Okay, so there is a question where you need to compute the linear as well as the circular periodic convolution, circular periodic or circular convolution of the given two sequences x1n and x2n. And also you need to find the circular convolution. So in this question, you need to find out circular convolution by using DFT and IDFT method also. Okay. So here the name of the method that you need to use to find the circular convolution is mentioned already. So you have to apply in the C part the DFT and IDFT method to find out the circular convolution. So just we will be seeing. So to find out the linear convolution, we have seen a method. Linear convolution, okay. So how we find it? Like we will be writing the x1 and x2 two sequences, whatever two sequences are there. So x1 is 1 1 2 2, so we will write 1 1 2 2, and the another sequence x2 is 1 2 3 4, so we will be writing it one on the column side, vertical side, another one on the horizontal side. What we will do, we will multiply one by one. So two will be, this one will be multiplied with one, we will be writing here. One will be multiplied by this one, we will write here. This one will be multiplied by this two, we will write two here. This one will be multiplied by this two, we will write here two. Okay. So again, two will be multiplied with each of the horizontal component, the x1 step, whatever signal is there. So two will be multiplied by one. This will be two. Two will be multiplied by one. Okay. So we will keep on multiplying. Two will be multiplied by two. That is four. And two again will be multiplied by two. We will write it here. So that's like that. We will be multiplying all the components, all the sequences with each other, and then the final output of the linear convolution we will be getting, that is x of three, will be equals to x1n convolution with, this is the convolution sign, this is the convolution sign, x2 signal, and that we will get is the first one, the first element will be the first value, the first step. Then we will separate it by a line. The next two values we will separate it like that. Like that we will separate the multiplied value that we have got, and the first step value will be there. That says for n equals to 0, so this will be for n equals to 0, that value will be 1. The second value will be sum of 2 and 1, so 2 and 1 will be 3, so this will be 3. Then the third value will be 3 plus 2 plus 2, that is 4 plus 3, that is 7. Okay, so this is for n equals to 2. 2. This is 1. This is for n equals to 1. This is for 2. And for 3, we will be adding 4 plus 3 plus 4 plus 2. That is 8 plus 2, 10 plus 3, 13. Okay, so this will be 13. Again, 4 and 6 and 4. 8 plus 6. 8 plus 6 will be 14. So that's why we will keep on adding, and finally, we will get up to 8 plus 6 is 14 again, and 8, the last one will be 8. Okay, so this number of steps, sequences will be 1, 3, 7, 13, 14, 14, and 8. So this will be your linear convolution value of the x1 and x2. Okay, so we have used some other mathematical method. This is also a method to find out the same, similar to mathematical, but the representation is different. Okay. The next B point is to find out the circular convolution of two sequences. So we have already seen that what is the formula for circular, this is formula for circular convolution. Here the second, this sequence will be circularly convolved. This is circular shift, this is circular shift, and with m steps. So based on the m value, we will be shifting this x2 signal. So this is the circular shift. So to find out the circular convolution, we have used, what is we have used is graphical method we have used. even we can use the Rafigan method, or we can use the matrix method also. Okay, and one method is DFT and IDFT. So DFT and IDFT, we need to find it in the C part, so we will be using either graphical or matrix method. So here the x to minus n is the sequence that is called time reversal of x to signal, or we call it a folded sequence. So if x2 is folded means we have just reversed its time domain. So n value is there, if we put minus sign against the n, that will be called a reverse sequence, or we call it a folded sequence. So x2 will be folded. So once we have found out x2 folded with zero shift, that will be multiplied by x1 with respect to sequence values, and we will be getting the first y of 0. Sorry, this is instead of y, we are here calculating x of 3. So x of 3, to find out x of 3, we will be putting n equals to 0. So after putting n equals to 0, this will be the condition. So the circular shift of x2, that means the folded sequence we need to find out. So folded sequence is finded out like in a circular shift. So instead of writing in anti-clockwise, we will be writing in clockwise. If the clockwise written, that means it will be a so this clockwise direction shows a x2 minus n capital N, this shows the circular shift. Okay, so this shift will be multiplied by the x1 signal. So whatever we are having the x1 signal. Okay, so this will be your x1 signal. So whatever their respective sequence value will be there, that will be multiplied, and we will be getting, after adding, we will get the x3 0 value. Okay, so similarly x3 0 we will be getting. Again, if we are shifting x2 with respect to circular shift with one step, we will be after that we will be multiplying x1 again, and we get the x3 1, and similarly 2 and 3 that we have already seen by using the circular shift method or graphical method. So this graphical method is showing x1 is there. So this x1 will be represented in the form of anti-clockwise. Okay, so x0, x11, x12, x13 values are there. Similarly, we will write x2 will be x20, x21, x23, 2 and x23 to find out its shift, that is folded sequence. So this will be the folded sequence of x2. So x2n, the folded value will be given by the same sequence will be retained in, instead of anti-clockwise, we will be writing in clockwise direction. So x20 will be here, x21 will be there, x22, x23. This is called the folded sequence. Okay, so this is folded sequence. So this sequence will be multiplied by this one once, and after multiplication of these two, we will be getting x30. Okay, similarly x1n will be multiplied by x2n, this will be giving you the x3. Then again one folded sequence will be shifted by one unit. Okay, this is folded, x2 minus n will be shifted by one unit, and whatever result is there, that will be multiplied. So after multiplication, we will be getting the x3 1. Similarly, we will be getting x3 2, and similarly we will be getting x3 3. So we have done this already in the previous class also. The next part is C, by using the DFT and IDFT method. So by using DFT and IDFT method also we have seen. So you can go through that how it is been solved. We have already discussed that. So in the first part, we will be finding out the DFT of x1 signal and x2 signal, and that two signals will be multiplied, and whatever DFT we will be getting, then we will find the IDFT. Okay, and that finally we will be getting the x3 of, and that will be the circular convolution. Okay, so this method we have already seen, so just go through it. Okay, so we will be moving forward to the next topic. So this example we have already seen, so that's why I am just skipping it. Okay, so our next topic is past Fourier transform. So up to the previous one, we have seen what is DFT, that is discrete Fourier transform. So one of the way to find out, the easiest way to find out the DFT is by using fast Fourier transform algorithms. Okay, so basically these fast Fourier transform algorithms are divided into two parts. One is DIT, that is decimation in time. Another one is decimation in frequency. This is decimation in time, and another one is decimation in frequency. So decimation means we need means break, to break. Okay, so decimation in time means whatever sequence is there given in the x and that is time domain form, we will be breaking it into odd and even parts. We will keep on breaking this given sequence into the time domain to two different sequences, and we will be finding out their individual DFTs, and individual DFTs, and we will be combining all to find out the final DFT, that is called DIT, that is decimation in time. The second method is decimation in frequency. Here the xk, that is, this is the xk is the frequency domain representation of the signal. So xk is divided into two parts, that is odd and even. And then finally, with respect to the component, that means with respect to our input, we will be getting this xk value. So that is given by decimation and frequency. Okay, so here we will see, this is the your xk, the formula for finding, or this is the DFT formula that we have already seen. So in that DFT formula, this part is represented by up to here, or we can write this part as Wn to the power kn. We have seen previously, like, what is this Wn is called the Tudel factor. So this Wn will be a complex valued phase factor. This is complex valued phase factor. So whatever is written in the form of e to the power j theta, so this theta value will be showing you the phase factor. So any value is there, that is a complex, this represents a complex value, and the theta value represents the phase of that complex value. Okay, so we will be writing it out Wn terms, in terms of Wn, and we can see, like, Wn is given by e to the power minus j 2 pi by n. Okay, so this Wn basically represents the nth root of unity. So nth root of unity means whatever this, if this is 1, so what will be the 1 by nth root, we will be finding out, or you can say we will be finding out this 1 by, sorry, nth root, the nth root of 1. So not only here 1 is there, we can find out, like, it is written like e to the power minus j 2 pi n k divided by n. Okay, so whatever term is there, that will be in the form of cos 2 pi n k by n minus j, similarly sine, the same term. So if it is written in terms of 2 pi, okay, so 2 pi terms is there, so this 2 pi will always be, and this if any, this cos function and sine functions are always periodic with 2 pi, so it will always be having for all different values of n, we will be getting this value as 1, and this value will be like 0. So that's why if we are making Wn to the power kn, okay, so we can say, like, this is similar to 1 to the power something. Okay, so unity power, so nth root of unity, we can call it. So whatever values it is having, so this is n is given below. So either we are taking 2 pi nk, then 2 pi nk will be having a value of 1. Similarly, we can make it the power 1 by n. So this can be represented like the nth root of unity. So this is just a representation. So these formulas we have already seen, and similarly for IDFT we will be representing it in the terms of a Tidal factor like this. So in the first form, what we will do is we are just converting it into the real and imaginary part. So whatever xk we are getting, that is a DFT value, we are representing it in real part and imaginary part. And by using the formula, we can represent this signal, your x input signal, whatever xn is there, we can represent it also in the form of real and imaginary part. So this is xi, okay, this is xr, and this is jxi. So it can be represented in terms of real and imaginary part. And this e to the power minus j 2 pi kn divided by n was converted into this part, okay, in the cos and sine form. This is given by the Euler's formula that we have already known, okay. So after separating the real and imaginary part, we can see like x of r into k, that is x of DFT part of real part of DFT will be given by this formula, and the imaginary part, this is I, will be given by this component, okay. So this is just a separation of DFT that we will be getting in the form of real and imaginary part. There, this Tidal factor that we see, this is Tidal factor Wn. Tidal factor has two properties. The first one is symmetry property, and the second one is periodicity property. So this symmetry property says like, if Wn is there and it is having a power of k plus n by 2, then it will be equals to minus Wn to the power k. That means if it is similar to like, it is showing odd behavior with respect to n by 2. Okay, so it is having a symmetry. This property is called symmetry property. Another one property is periodicity. If Wn is having to the power k, if we add n into it, so Wn to the power k plus n is there, it will be equals to Wn to the power k. Okay, that means for n time period, it is showing the periodic nature. Okay, this is its period, time period. So Wn has two properties, symmetry and periodicity property. These two properties will be used for further analysis. Okay, so we will analyze the radix 2 FFT. So what is here radix, we will see. So what happens, to find out the DFT, what we do is there should be n, and this n should be power of 2 to the power r, something we call it, okay. So this DFT could be even 2 to the power, this is 2 to the power r, even it could be 3 to the power r also, okay. Here it could be 4 to the power r also, okay. So if the DFT calculation is such that here n is equals to 2 to the power r is considered for DFT calculation, then that DFT will be called radix 2 DFT, okay. So this will be, if n value, that is the number of samples in a sequence, if that is having n value and that n can be represented in the form of 2 to the power r, then that DFT calculation will be called radix 2 DFT, okay. If r, if that n value represents a 3 to the power r or other some other value, then this will be called radix 3 DFT, and this will be radix 4. So for a clear, or you can say basic understanding, we use only the radix 2 FFT algorithm, and this is only in our this syllabus of this course. So we will be basically studying radix 2 FFT algorithms only. So here, like how it has been came, like derived, like it should be radix 2 DFT, n value can be represented with different factors, okay, this different sizes. So if r r's r becomes equal, then it will be n equals to r to the power l. So this r value, if this r is having two size, then this two sized n value will be called your radix function. So this will be called a radix 2 function. So whenever DFT calculation will be there that is having a r size, okay, and where r is called the radix, and this r is 2, then it will be called radix 2. Similarly, if r is something different one, it will be called some other radix value. So we will be basically finding out the radix 2 FFT algorithm. So it will be divided into two parts, that is DIT and DIF, dismission in time and dismission in frequency. So we will see one by one. We will see also that what is the difference between basic DFT and FFT algorithm. So what is how the DFT, basic DFT and FFT is different from each other. So what happens in FFT algorithms, what we do is any endpoint DFT is there. Okay. So what we call it, if endpoint DFT is there, we will divide it into n by 2 part point and n by 2 point. Means we will divide it half. Okay. So once we will divide it half, we will find out the complexity, that how it is simple than the other. So whatever DFT, basic DFT is there. So in that basic DFT, just see the formula. Okay. So suppose this is the formula. This is the formula for DFT calculation. Okay. So from this formula, you can find like how many number of multipliers we need to have. So this is a value, and this will be another value. Okay. So these two will be multiplied, and then the first term will be calculated, and then that will be added for different n values. So it will be after expansion, we will get like we need n number of multipliers. Because n times these two, because 0 to n minus 1, there are n values are there in this xn sequence. So n number of multipliers we need. Okay. Is it clear to everyone? Like this term is one term and this is another term. These two terms are being multiplied with each other for n equals to 0 one time, then again for n equals to 2 times, so n up to n minus 1 times. So total n times multiplication we need. So n multipliers will be required. Similarly, all multiplied elements will be added to n minus 1 times. Okay, so total n minus 1 adders will be required, because if n terms are there, suppose five terms are there, so five terms are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We need to add 5 terms. So how many adders are required? 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if 5 terms are there, 5 minus 1. 5 minus 1 number of adders will be required. Okay. Similarly, n terms are there. Total 0 to n minus 1, n terms are there. So n minus 1 adders will be required. Okay. So to find out the DFT of this by this formula, we need n number of multipliers and n number of adders. Okay, that is clear. So we will see, like if normal DFT is there, that is of endpoint DFT, we are using normal DFT formula, we are finding out the endpoint DFT. So n number of multipliers we require, okay, and n minus 1 number of adders we require. This is multipliers and this is adders. So total we need n into n minus 1. So this could be the, you can say, the complexity that we can define just in terms of adder or multiplier. Similarly, suppose we are using FFT algorithm. In FFT algorithm, we need to again find out the endpoint DFT, similar to this DFT. We need to find out endpoint DFT, but what we are doing is we are dividing it into two parts. That is endpoint DFT, n by 2 point DFT and n by 2 point DFT. Now we will see the number of multiplier and adders. So if n by 2 number of points are there and we need to find out DFT, so we will be requiring n by 2 number of multipliers, and here also we will be requiring n by 2 number of multipliers and n by 2 minus 1 number of adders. So this is for multiplier, this is for adders, and then here also n by 2 minus 1 number of adders are required. So if we add these two, it will be 2 times n by 2, that is n number of multipliers are there. So similarly, we will add these two again, and we will find out the same, like it will be again 2 times n minus 1. Okay, so we can find n minus 2. Okay, so we can see like if these calculations are being done in computer, so once one adder is there, again this, once this is this number of calculation has been done, then again this number of calculation we need to perform are having the same order. So we can use the same number of complexity, the same number of hardwares to find out this calculation also. So in case of n point DFT, n by 2 point DFT, we will be basically requiring the you can say number of adders and multipliers that we'll be requiring will be half, almost half, because this will be again repeating. So we'll be having same number of hardwares at once. This number of hardwares will be sufficient to find out the calculation of another n by 2 point DFT. So in case of normal DFT, we will be requiring almost, if we neglect this one, almost n square will be the complexity. Similarly, in case of this, we will be having n by 2 square number of complexity, or similar we can say. Okay, so we will be having almost half number of complexity in case of this one. So complexity we will finding n plus n by 2 whole square divided by plus n by 2 whole square. So finally we will be finding out like n square by 2 will be the total complexity in case of FFT algorithm, and n square complexity in terms of normal DFT calculation. So because of this complexity comparison, we can be switching to find out DFT from normal DFT method to FFT algorithms. Okay, in that FFT algorithms, DIT and DIF methods will be used. Okay, so we will see their complexities further. Okay, later into the course. So first of all, we will be starting with DIT algorithm. So in this DIT algorithms, as the name is there, decimation in time. So we will be decimating with respect to time. So time means if xn is there, we will be dividing this xn into even part and again another, that is odd part. So this xn will be divided into two parts, and we will be calculating DFT of these even parts separately and the odd parts separately, and then that will be added finally to get out the overall the DFT. Okay. So this is the DFT formula. So we will break it into two numbers, that is odd and even and odd numbers. So this will be added like here n is varying from 0 to n minus 1. So again here n is equal to 0 to n minus 1, but only for n that is having even numbers. Okay. So xn will be there. Similarly, for all the odd n values ranging from 0 to n minus 1 will be for the second odd sequence. Okay. So if this is even, we can put this n value to n number that will be 2r, where 2r will be representing an even number. So n will be replaced by 2r for even. And similarly, n will be replaced for the odd is as 2r plus 1. Okay. This is just a representation how that how we represent an odd and even number. So we will be putting this n as 2r in case of the first one, and this n in terms of 2r plus 1 in the second part. Okay. So whenever there will be n, that n will be replaced by 2r. So 2r will be 0. So similarly here, this is n equals to 0 and this is n equals to n minus 1. Similarly, once we will be putting n equals to 2r, so it will become n by 2 minus 1. So whatever n number of sequences are there, we will be dividing it to n by 2 minus 1. Okay, so starting with 0 up to 2n minus n by 2 minus 1 sequence, it will be going, and x 2r will be represented, and here instead of n will be written as 2r. Similarly, in this case, the r sequence will be ranging from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. So this total will be n by 2 sequences are divided here, and this will be n by 2 sequences. Okay. So out of total n sequences. So in this case, total n number of points are there, sequences are there. So but in case of here, n by 2 and n by 2 points are there, total will be n by 2. So whenever n will be there, it will be written 2r plus 1 for odd one. Okay, this is for odd side, this is for even side. And here also n is there, this n will be replaced by 2r plus 1. So we'll further simplify it and make it like this: 2r written, 2 was taken inside, and to the power rk was written. Similarly, in the previous case, this whole signal x 2r plus 1 will be multiplied by this one, this wn to the power 2r plus 1k. So 2rk will be separated and 2r into k will be taken outside. Okay, so here wn to the power k will be taken outside and 2n to the power 2r was there, 2 will be taken inside. Okay. So this wn to the power 2 is given by e to the power minus j 2 pi by n to the power 2. So if this 2 is there, so 2 power can be written as this one, like e to the power minus j 2 pi by n by 2. Okay, so here if it was e to the power minus j 2 pi by n, then we were writing wn. Similarly, if it is e to the power j 2 pi by n by 2, then we can write it w to the base n by 2. So we will be replacing this one by this term w to the power w to the base n by 2. Okay. So we will be writing this equation in the form of this. So n should be varying from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. 2r, it will be written this, and this again will be written there. Okay. So one thing we can notice, this is having a range from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. So n by 2 terms are there. And this is having w n by 2 terms, so it is like similar the formula of a 2 point DFT or n by 2 point DFT. It is similar to n by 2 point DFT of x of 2r. So if this x of 2r is this complete DFT is written by g of k, another DFT of odd sequence of xn, we can write it as a n by 2 point DFT. This is n by 2 point DFT. And again, this complete will be taken as n by 2 point DFT, that is represented by h of k, and this will be separated here, multiplied. So this will be again n by 2 point DFT. So here total, this will be n by 2 point DFT, n by 2 point DFT, and individual k values should be varying from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. Okay. So this is the value, like either this k is being varied from 0 to n by 2 minus 1. So this is only defined for 0 to n by 2 minus 1. So again, to find out, because k should be varying from 0 to up to n minus 1. Okay, it should be having n terms. So to find out the next terms, that is after n by 2 minus 1, it will be n by 2, and again n by 2 minus 1, and keep on increasing up to n minus 1. It should be like that, the final n by 2 terms. So similarly, this is the DFT also. So this DFT should also be following the periodicity property. Okay, and as it is n by 2 point DFT, so it will be defined for having a period of n by 2. So the same sequence will be showing a periodic property with a period of n by 2. So again, this h of k for next sequence, the next sequence ranging from n by 2 minus 1 to next terms. So up to, this is, suppose this is the first term, 0 to n by 2 minus 1, and this is next n by 2 terms, this is n by 2 terms. So if this is defined for n by 2 terms, then again it will be defined with a period of n by 2 terms. So next sequence will be again given by n by 2 to n minus 1. Here we will be replacing, whenever there is k is written, that k will be written by, replaced by k plus n by 2, and here is k is written, so k plus n by 2 will be writing, we will be writing. This k will be replaced by k plus n by 2, because whatever we have got, this should be periodic with respect to n by 2 time period. Okay, so as in the previous slide, we have seen like DFTs are this periodic with respect to the time period. So by that formula, we can write this also. So here at x of k can be defined between 0 to n by 2 minus 1, and then again after the next term will be n by 2 minus 2 n minus 1. Okay, So finally, by the symmetry formula in this term, we can make it like if it is w n to the power k plus n by 2, we can write it minus, because if n by 2 plus is given, it should be written as it as minus. So we can convert it, instead of plus, we can write it minus, and it will be w n. So in this symmetry part, we can just see like here plus is there, here minus is there. So up to n by 2 minus 1 terms, this will be plus. After that, it will be negative. That means up to half terms, it will be positive, and up to half terms, it will be negative. So from the figure 1, how this formula can be depicted, like it can be seen some confusing or something complex. So we'll make it simple. So this is the formula. Okay, so that formula can be represented in the form of diagram. So this is called flow graph. Okay, so this diagram that we see is called a flow graph of the second stage dissemination in time. So what happens, there are different stages, so that we will be seeing in a couple panel of one. So if any 8-point sequence is there, so in this 8-point we will be breaking it into 4-point and 4-point calculation, and this 4-point will be further broke into 2-point and 2-point calculation, and this 2-point and 2-point. So we will be keep on breaking the given sequence so that we finally reach to a 2-point DFT. So to find out a 2-point DFT is the simplest one. This is the simplest one. Okay. So we will be finally dividing a sequence and this n value to such that finally at the end we should be getting a 2-point DFT. If we have got the 2-point DFT, that means we have completed all the dissemination part. So if 8-point sequence is there, it should be first divided into 4-part. Okay, so like this, if 8-point DFT is there, this has been divided into this 4-part, 4 terms, like this 4 terms, g of k was there, that g of k was for the even point DFT. This is even point DFT up to here. So it is up to here, it is even point, and this is for odd point. Okay, so this 8-point of DFT is divided into 4-part. Okay, so similarly, this 4 parts will further be divided. Okay, so this is just the explanation of the this graph, and how we have got this graph is from this formula. From this formula, if we will be putting the k value from 0 up to 0 to 7, we will be getting this relationship that we have finally derived. So if this x of 0 will be g of 0 plus this plus will be there, h of 0 multiplied by w n 0. So x of 0 will be we will write it like x of 0 will be written as g of 0 plus w n to the power 0 into h of 0. Okay, so this is how we will be depicting like x of 0, how this is defined. Similarly, if x of 4 is there, how it is written, so it will be h of 0, this is h of 0, so this will be h of 0 plus this multiplication will be, h of 0 will be multiplied by w n to the power 4, and plus this will be g of 0. So this is how we will be calculating. With the help of an example, it will be easy to understand. Okay. Okay. So next, the same. Once we have find out the g of k, okay, and we have find out the h of k in the previous calculation. Similarly, this g of k and h of k will be again divided into odd and even part. Similarly, in the previous x of k, what we have done is, x of k, whatever signal was there, it was divided into odd and even. Okay, so odd and even. Similarly, g of k will be defined by some function. Suppose g of r is a function. The g of r will be divided into odd and even. Okay, so this is the even function, similar to the previous one, and this will be the odd function. And after getting the division and calculation, finally we will be getting g of k will be given by another a of k plus w of k to the power to the base n by 2 into bk. Okay, these are the another dissemination. This was called the first stage sorry, this was called the second stage, because if it is 8 point, it has given the second stage, and this will be the first stage. Okay, so this will be the first stage destination. Similarly, h of k, that will be odd, it can further be divided into odd and even. Okay, even and odd, and we will be getting h of k, c of k plus w k n by 2 dk. Okay, so after incorporating or the this was the second stage, and this is called the first stage. The first stage, this is g of k, sorry, g of k is divided into two different odd and even parts. Here h of 4, h of k value will be there, it will be divided into odd, even and odd part. Okay, so this is the second stage, this is the first stage, this is how we represent. So by putting the k equals to 0 value, so once we have put the k equals to 0 value, what will be the value of g0 in terms of a and b? It has been solved by putting the k value. So similarly, we have got the h value also. From g value, we can also get the h value similarly. So final, at the final point, we can say at the end, whenever when we will be reaching the 2 point DFT, at 2 point DFT, the flow graph, whatever flow graph will be there, this is called 2 point DFT, or we call it butterfly structure. Okay, this is called butterfly structure, and this is for DIT. So this butterfly will be for DIT algorithm. Okay, so this is the DIT for butterfly structure. The 2 point DFT will be given as the butterfly structure. Okay, so in that we will be finally getting, like, this is f of 0, f of 1, this is the simplified one, the last stage value. So it will be the sum of this first one, f of 0 will be f of 0 plus w 2, because it is 2 point DFT, so n will be 2, so w 2 to the power 0, okay, into f of 1, this f of 1 will be f of 0. Okay, similarly f of 1 will be given like f of 0 plus f of 1 into w 2 to the power, okay, w 2 to the power n by 2, sorry, the same one value will be there, here 0 value is there, w 2 to the power 1 will be there. Okay, that will be given w n to the power n by 2 is equals to minus 1. So finally it will be w 2 to the power 1 will be f 0 minus f 1. So this is the butterfly structure, and this is the how its function are defined. So this is the final your flow graph for 8 point DFT. So you need to keep in mind, and the previous slide we have seen the butterfly structure. So this is the generalized butterfly for DIT algorithm. This is the generalized structure for generalized butterfly structure. So here we call it, the sequences will be x0 up to x7, but here the order of the sequences will be different. X0 is there, x4 is there, x2 is there. Okay, but at the end we will be getting x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x6, x7. And at the first, how this bit reversal is being done is given by this table. So at the starting, it should be like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 7, it should be there. But because in this, while performing the DIT, we should be having DIT, we should be performing the bit reversal sequence at the input. So in that DIT, the bit reversal at input is taken place, and how this bit reversal is being done, like, and whatever value is there, decimal value, it will be converted into binary. Then binary to a reversed binary we need to write. So like 0 will be written at this. If 001 is given, its bits are reversed. So this 1 will become at the first instead of the last, it should be here. So it will be just their bits with respective bits will be reversed. So it will be instead of 001, it should be written as 100. If it is 010, again it will, after reversing, it will be the same. If it is 1011, it's after reversal, it will be 110. Okay, similarly we will reverse it. If it is 1 1 0, after reverse it will be 0 1 1. So whatever its boundary value will be there, 0 is there, this is 100, that is 4, this is 100, that is 2, 110, that is 6, this is 1, this is 5, this is 3, and this is 7. So this will be the sequence that is written here. Okay, this x0 will be coming to the first one, this is 0, then x4 will be there, this is the x4 value, x2 will be there, so this is x2. Okay, similarly x6, then x1, x5, x3, and x7. So this is at the starting, you need to keep in mind, like we do not write in the binary order, like a normal binary order. It should be reversed. Its binary sequences will be reversed, and it should be written like 0, 2, 4, and 6. The sequences, the input sequences will be written in this order. And these two, to find out the DFT by using DIT FFT algorithm, we should be given this sequence. So by combining these two sequences with this type of multiplication, we will be getting A0. This is called the first stage. This is called the second stage, and this is called the third stage. So how the stages are defined, we will see. So here, if n is the number of points, so n is the number of point of DFT we need to find out. So this n, the number of stages. So how many number of stages are required are given by L will be equals to log to the base 2 into n. If n is 8, then L value will be 3, or n equals to 8. So if n equals to 8 point DFT we need to find out, then L number of stages will be required. Okay. So similarly, this is the flow graph of 8 point DFT. So in that, we will be requiring first, second, and third stages. So if this sequence is given, we will first find out A0, A1, B0, B1, C0, C1, D0, D1, and then with respect to A1, A and B, we will be finding out G. Okay, then with respect to C and D value, we will be finding out H0, H1, H2, H3, and with respect to G and H, we will be finding out the X value. Okay, so this is how the DIT algorithm works for n equals to 8 point DFT. Okay, so we will see the same after simplification. Okay, so like here it is written W to the power 2 to the base 2. Okay, this value after simplification, so this is the reduced final 8 point DFT algorithm. Okay, this is reduced flow graph, so this should be used for like it should be used for calculations. ठीक है, सो हम एक एग्जाम्पल देखेंगे, एग्जाम्पल से हमें ये थोड़ा इजिली समझ में आएगा. ठीक है, सो वी विल टेक एन एग्जाम्पल. सो सपोज दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल वी हैव बीन गिवन, जस्ट 2 मिनट. So we'll take an example, like suppose x of n is 8 point DFT is given. So it is having a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here n is 8 given. So in the previous examples, so whatever examples we have taken, always xn was having n equals to 4. Up to 4 terms we have used, so that up to 4 terms it is easy to calculate by using your formula method. So formula method up to 4 it will be easy, but after it is having larger value than 8, larger sequences, then we need to have some efficient algorithms like DIT and FFT algorithm. So for higher value of n, we should be using these FFT algorithms. So in this example, just wait for a minute. Okay, so in this example, so n equals to 8 is given, and also while calculating all the values in this program, we just keep like we need to have the value of W80, and we need to have the value of W8 to the power 2. Similarly, from here we can write like W8 to the power 0, W8 to the power 1, W8 to the power 2, W8 to the power 3. These four values are the values that we should be having before going for the calculation. Okay, so calculate karne se pehle hum kyun sabse pehla method sabse pehle hum kya karenge, sabse pehle ye values find out karenge. Okay, so if it is n equals to 8, so putting n equals to 8 and with power 0, 1, 2, 3. So first step will be this one, to find out W80 to the power 0, it will always be a 1 value. Similarly, W8 to the power 1 will be given by 8 to the power j, 2 pi by n equals to 8 will be there. So 2 pi by 8 will be with power 1. So 1 will be there. So after expansion, it will be cos pi by 4 plus, it is minus. So it will be minus j sine pi by 4. So it is 0.707. minus j 0.707. okay, so these are the values you can even remember, like it will be 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 root 2. So okay, so from there we can just have, and W8 to the power 2 is equals to e to the power minus j, then 2 pi by 8 into it is power 2. So after doing the power, we can have is equals to cos pi by 2 minus j sine pi by 2 is equals to minus j. So from there we can find out the value of this your W8 2 and W8 3. So this, once we have find out these values, we can use directly to find out the sequence of x of k. So in the next slide, we will be, with the help of this, what we need to do is we will be finding out this value. So this is your A0 value, and this is your this is A0, this is A1, this is B0 value, and this is B1. Again, this is C0 value, this is C1, this is D0 value, and this is D1 value. Okay, so we need to have all these values. Okay, so we will find out these values, and after that, after finding out these values, we will be finding g of 0. Okay, so this will be g of 1, g of 2, g of 3, and then this will be h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, and h of 3. So to finally get x of 0, x1, x of 1, x of 2, we should be having starting with a0 and a1. So in this part we will find out, so what will be the different values in terms of a0 and a1. So by the method that we have the formula, from there the formula we can directly find out the value. So just it will be easy for you to write it down. So we are taking the separate sheet, so from there we will be finding out. Okay, just wait for a minute. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so we are having x of 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. So this is your x n values there. Okay, so we need to find out a0. This a0. Okay, so this a0 will be equals to, by this flow diagram, so a0 will be equals to this, first of all, x0 plus this x4 multiplied by w80, and this w80 is equals to 1, so it will be x0 plus x4. So the first one value will be there, that will be x0 plus x4. Okay, and again it will be a1 value will there. So this a1 value will be there, x of 0, and from this, so is this a1 value will be there, x of 0 will be this coming to this way, arrow is showing this way, and then the second value will be x of 4 multiplied by w80, that is 1, so x4 will be multiplied by 1, and then again it is multiplied by minus 1, so it will be x of 0, it will be minus x of 4. So x of 0 is this one, so this is x of 0, this is 1, plus x of 4 will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this will be your x of 4. Okay. So this is your 4, so it will be 5. Similarly, we will be making 1 minus 4, so it will be minus 3. Similarly, we will find out b0 and b1 value. Okay. So from this graph, this flow, that flow graph, b0 will be given by x2 plus this w80 will be 1. So the x2 will be there plus x6. So this will be x2 plus x6. Similarly, b1 will be x2 minus x6. So x2 value is, x2 is, this is 1, this is 2, 3 plus 4, it is 5 and 6, that is 2, so it will be 5. And again it is 3 minus 2 will be 1, okay. So similarly, we will be finding out C0 and C1. And then again, D0 and D1. So from the graph, we will be finding C0 will be equals to X1 plus X5, okay. So this is X1 plus X5. And again, C1 will be X1 minus X5. So X1 is 2 plus X5 is 3. So it is 5. X1 is 2 minus 3 is equals to minus 1. So similarly, the D0 and D1 will be X3 plus X7. So this is X3 plus X7, this will be X3 minus X7. So it will be X7, X3 value is 4 plus X7 is 1. And then 4 minus 1, so it will be 5, and this will be 3. Okay, so this is the values of A0, A1, B0, B1, C0, C1, D0, D1. Okay, so once we have find out these values, we will be using to find out the next values. Okay, so next values will be G0, G1, G2, G3. Similarly, we will be finding out H0, H1, H2, H3. So just we will see, G0 will be given by A0, whatever A0 we have find out is A0 plus W8 to the power 0 is always 1. So A0 plus B0. So A0 plus B0 value will be given by G0. Okay. A0 plus B0 will be given. So in the previous one, from there, A0 is 5 and B0 is also 5. Okay. So this will be 5 plus 5 is equals to 10. Similarly, G1, we need to find out the G1. So this G1 will be A1 plus B1 multiplied by W8 to the power 2. So from there we need to find out w8 to the power 2 also. Okay, so it will be w8 to the power 2 value is minus j. Okay, this is 2, so this is w8 to the power j. So we will be having g1 is equals to a1 minus j. Okay, b1. Okay, so this was the value. This g1 is a1 plus b1 multiplied by this w a to the power 2, that was minus j. Okay, so we need to put the value of a1 and b1 from the next value. So a1 is given by minus 3 and b1 is 1. So this is minus 3 minus j and b1 is 1. So it will be minus 3 minus j. So this will be your g1 value. Similarly, we can find out the g2 value and g3 value similarly. Okay, so from there we can find out all the values of g0 to g3, and similarly h0 to h3. ठीक है, फाइंड आउट हो जाएगा सबसे. कुछ वैल्यूज और ले लेते हैं. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट वैल्यू है g2. सो दिस g2 वैल्यू इज गिवन बाय दिस a0, व्हाट एवर a0 इज देयर. ओके, देन b0 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय w8 0, दैट इज अगेन द b0 विद द माइनस साइन. सो अगेन इट विल बी a0 माइनस b0 विल बी देयर. सो दिस इज 5 minus 5 equals to 0. Similarly, this g3 value will be there. A1 value there. Okay, so this is a1 and this is b1 multiplied by w8 to the power 2, that is equals to minus j. So we can write it here. This is minus j, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. It will be easy. Okay, so this is again 1 and this is minus j. So we were finding out g3. So g3 is a1, okay, a1, that will be then plus b1 multiplied by minus j, and here again a minus 1 is there. Okay, so this minus 1 is there, so minus 1 will be multiplied by j, will be plus j and b1. So finally we will be having a1 plus j b1. Okay, so a1 is minus 3 plus j multiplied by 1 equals to minus 3 plus j. ठीक है, ये समझ में आया. ये फाइंड आउट के लिए हमने g1 वैल्यू, सो वट एवर वैल्यूज वी हैव फाइंड आउट हियर, दिस इज कॉल्ड फर्स्ट स्टेज वैल्यू. एंड दीज वैल्यूज g एंड h विल बी कॉल्ड द सेकेंड स्टेज वैल्यूज. ओके, so similarly we can find out the h0 also. So this h0 will be equals to c0 plus d0. Similarly it will be here. So it is c1 minus j d1, and then it will be c0 minus d0 c1 plus j d1. So just we can put the value and get it. Just we can verify also. So this just you need to keep in mind, like this b0 value is value before w80. So this is the b0 value, this is b1, and this one is okay. Here a multiplier is there, so before multiplier whatever value is there, that is 0, d0 and d1. Okay, so this h0 will be c0 plus d0. Okay, h1 will be c1 plus d1 multiplied by minus j. And then h2 value, this will be before multiplier. So h2 value will be c0. This will be 1, then minus t0. Then h3 value will be there c1, and minus minus will be plus j, so plus j d1. Okay, so from there 5 and minus 1, 5 and 5. Okay, so this is 5 plus 5, this is 0, sorry, 10, and this is 5 minus 5, so it will be 0, and 1 and 1, so c1 and d1, c1 and d1, minus 1 and 3, so it is minus 1, minus j, and 3, it will be minus 1 minus 3 j, so it is minus 1, minus 1 and 3, minus 1 plus j, 3, this is j, it is minus 1 plus 2j. Okay, so up to here this is the value of second stage. So once we have find out the value of the second stage, z0, g1, g2, g3, and h0, h1, h2, h3, we can finally find out the value of x of 0. Okay, and then we can find out the x of 1 and x of 2 and up to x of 7. Okay, so just we will find out the one value. So we will go on to the graph. So x0 value is g0 plus this is 1 and this is minus. So it was plus 1.707 minus. So this is plus 0.707 minus j 7.707. okay, and this was minus j, and this is plus 0.707 plus j 707 point. okay, so just you can find out the see the values we have find out at the starting. So we will be multiplying x of 0 will be z0 multiplied by h of, sorry, add addition of h of 0. So this x of 0 will be g of 0 plus h of 0. So this is 10 plus 10 will be equals to 20. Okay, somewhere same way you have x1 will be g of 1. So whatever g of 1 will be there, and then it will be h of 1 multiplied by w8 to the power 1. So this is this value. So we will be having g of 1 plus w8 to the power 1 into h of 1. So it is g of 1 plus, it is 0.707 minus g times 0.707, that will be multiplied by h of 1. So we will be putting these values. Okay, so g of 1, so we will find out g of 1 is equals to minus 3 minus j, which is minus 3 minus j. Okay, plus this value 0.707 minus j 0.707 will be multiplied by h of 1. So h of 1 value is minus j minus 3j. This is minus 1 minus 3j. So after multiplying, we will be getting the value. Whatever value we will be getting, that will be the your x1 value. Okay, similarly we will be getting x of 2. Okay, and so on, whatever value we will be getting, that will be after the final calculation, that will be given by our x of k value. Okay, so that will be our DFT. So this is the final value that we will be getting. So after the multiplication overall, x of 0 will be this one, x of 1 will be this one, x of 2, x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6 and x of 7. So in between the intermediate values are also given, 10 minus 3 minus j 0. Okay, all these values should be matching whatever we have calculated. So there the 0 values, yes, the 0 values are there. So these values are matching. So at each stage we need to have the values. This is the first stage value, this is the second, and this is the final, the third stage value. Okay, so finally at the end we will be getting x of k equals to this one. Okay, so this is how we calculate the DIT, that is decimation in time FFT algorithm. The last topic that is having is that is similar to the one that we have studied. So FFT we will be just seeing like how we calculate the FFT. So similar to DIT algorithm, just go through the derivation part. We will just seeing the final numerical we will be saying or how we have just derived. So in DIF, that is decimation in frequency, so whatever XK formula is given, okay, so instead of dividing the sequence, what we are doing is we are dividing the n values. So x n, this n value is varying from 0 to n minus 2 minus 1. So at the starting, just to hit this. Okay. So in decimation in frequency, you can see like we are going to have the decimation in frequency algorithm. So n value, if it is x of k, capital X of k, that is DFT, that is having n equals to 0 to n minus 1. Okay, and this 0 to n minus 1, here x of n is there and it is having wn to the power n into k. Okay, so this is the DFT formula, normal DFT. So what we are doing is we are breaking this 0 to n minus 1 means total n points are there. It is n point DFT. Okay, this is n point DFT. Okay, this is n point DFT. We will be breaking it into two parts, that is n by 2 point and n by 2 points. So in the previous one, it was broken based on the even and odd function. Similarly, it will be broken here also. So first of all, we are breaking its time, the range, the summation range that is varying from 0 to n minus 1. We will be breaking it to 0 to n minus 2 minus 1. So it will be n point DFT. And similarly, we will be breaking next steps will be n equals to n by 2. 2 n minus 1 will be there. Okay, so we have just broke n equals to 0 to n minus 1 to two parts, that is n by 2 part either and n by 2 part this here. Okay, so based on that we finally should be taking summation term outside. To make the summation term outside, both the summation range should be same. So here n should be ranging from 0 to n by 2 minus 1, but here n is ranging from n by 2 to n minus 1. Okay, so to have a common summation, we should have the common range. So we will make the range common. Okay, so to make this range common, we keep this one as it is. We will change this one slightly. So here it is ranging from n by 2 to n minus 1. So we will be making this range also similar to this one. So we will be making this range similar to this one, that is n equals to 0 to n by 2 minus 1. To make this range to, look like this one, similar to the first one, we will change the n value. So here n value was changing from n by 2 and it was going to n minus 1. So if we replace this n by n plus n by 2, then if n is equals to 0, then the first term will be appearing, n by 2. If n is equals to n by 2 minus 1, okay, the n by 2 minus 1, then the last term will be appearing, that is n minus 1 will be appearing in this case. So in this term, we will be replacing this n by n plus n by 2. So whenever there will be n, that will be replaced by n plus n by 2. So this n will also be replaced by this n plus n by 2. Okay. So the first term was as it is, in the second term, this w n to the power n plus n by 2 into k was there. Okay, so we will be taking out n k term, and w n to the power n by 2 will be taken outside. So this term will be taken outside because it is having no dependence on, this term is having no dependence on n parameter. Okay, so this n variable is not affecting this one, so we'll be taking it out. So all the terms will be like that. So next we will be going like w n to the power n k into k can be expanded as this one, minus 1 to the power k. So in that formula, that term will be replaced by this minus 1 to the power k. Okay, all are same. So this summation terms are same, summation condition. So we will be taking it out, and we can make it x of n. So this x of n will be there, and then plus minus 1 to the power k, x of n plus n by 2 will be taken out. And then in bracket, these two are common to all the terms, so it will be taken out. Okay, so it will be similar to this. So this is the decomposing the sequence in frequency domain. So this by using this technique, we can decompose the sequence into frequency domain x of k into an even numbered sequence. Okay, that is x of 2r and an odd number 2r sequence, that is x of 2r plus 1, where r should be ranging from 0 to 0. So what we are doing is, so this is our overall xk value. So now in the previous one, we were using this x of n to decimate it into odd and even. Okay, but in case of frequency decimation, we will be decimating x of k into two parts, that will be x of even terms and x of odd terms. To write this, we will be replacing it x of 2r, and to make it odd, 2r plus 1 will be replaced. So xk will be replaced by x of 2r. So it will be only the component of even terms. So whenever k is used in this formula, this will be replaced by 2r. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so here the range is n equals to 0 to n by 2 minus 1 in the previous one. Here xn will be same, xn here. K was there, this k will be replaced by 2r. So minus 1 to the power 2r will always be a positive value. Okay, one value. So it will be nullified. You can say it will be 1. So it is just 1 multiplied by x n plus n by 2. In bracket, wn to the power 2r, 2 wn. Here basically it was having 2nr, so k was replaced by 2r, so w2 will be taken outside, and 2wn to the power 2 will be given by wn by 2. Okay, so it will be replaced by similar to this. So instead of this, we can write it similar to like. And also here in this case, because it is an n point DFT, so each term is saying this is saying like it is an n by 2 point DFT. So its range should be r should be ranging from 0 to n minus 2, n by 2 minus 1. Okay. And also this were used already. So similarly, we can write here in the previous one. So okay. So this was there. So we can write it here. So instead of n power point, it can be written in n by 2 point. Okay, so similarly we can derive for odd terms also. So x of 2r plus 1 will be derived like this by putting all k value with 2r plus 1. So finally we will be getting r should be ranging from 0 to n by 2 minus 1, and then from there this will be the odd part, x of odd part, that is x of 2r plus 1 will be given this way. And here x of n minus x of n plus n by 2, this wn to the power 2r into n and wr to the power n, this will be given. So from there we can find, like from equation 3, that is previous one equation, this one is equation 3. Okay, and this is equation 4. So from equation 4 and 3, the first stage value that will be decomposed after combining these components, the first value that will be giving the odd, sorry, this will be giving you the even sequence of xn. and this will be giving you the odd sequence of xn, okay, and that will be having a relation xn plus x n plus n by 2. Okay, this will be plus 1 and this will be the minus 1. So similarly for n point DFT, once we will be putting the value of different n values, because we should be requiring n value, g value should be ranging from z0 to g3, and similarly h should be 0 to h3. So by putting g equals to 1 to 3 in this equation, we can find the relation that how g1, g2 and g3 can be calculated, and h1 and h2 have h3 can be calculated. So based on these calculation values, we can find this. So in the decimation in time, we were starting with the end part. Okay, so this was the last stage, but in the DIT FFT algorithm, we will be starting with the first part. So here, this with respect to these given sequences, the first stage will be calculated first. Okay, this will be the first stage. So G0, G1, G2, G3. Okay, and then again, this G0, G1, G2, G3 will be subdivided into odd and even parts. So this is the first stage computation. So flow graph of first stage of DIF FFT algorithm for n equals to 8. Similarly, this second term will be g of n will be like g of r. It will be given divided into g of odd and g of even. So this is even for g of n sequence. Similarly, this is the odd one also. This is okay. So from there, we will be dividing this odd even one with respect to odd and even. So further, even and odd part will be divided. And finally, we will be getting A0 and A1, similar to the previous derivation. It is in opposite direction, but it is similar to the previous one. Okay. So from there, we can get the B0 and B1 values. Similarly, other values will be given. So this is the final stage. This is the second stage, sorry. So this is the second stage. After that, we will be getting the final one. And this is the basic butterfly structure. So basic butterfly structure is, the butterfly structure is given for only the 2-point DFT. That is the smallest DFT possible, that is 2-point DFT. Whatever flow graph is there, flow graph of 2-point DFT will be called your basic butterfly structure. Okay, so this is basic butterfly structure in case of DIF algorithm. So A will be there, so it will be the DFT part will be A plus B. But in the second part, it should be A minus B, A minus B whole to the multiplied WN to the power R. So in the DIT, the multiplication, this multiplication factor was written at this place. Okay. So here it was WN to the power R. But in case of DIF FFT algorithm, the butterfly structure, this multiplication factor will be at the start end part. That means after subtracting, you will be multiplying. But in case of the DIF FFT algorithm, the first one was the A, then after multiplication of B into the multiplication factor, we were subtracting from the A. Okay, so this is the basic difference between the two butterfly structures you need to keep in mind. Okay,
so time
this. So this is your reduced flow graph of the final stage of DIF FFT algorithms. So here also, just you need to remember, like in DIF FFT algorithm, the input stages will be given by 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 7. But at the output, the obtained DFT, this is the obtained DFT, this will be having the bit reversal. Here, bit reversal is there. So starting at will be x of 0, then x of 4, x of 2, x of 6, x of 1, x of 5, x of 3, and x of 7. So how this bit reversal has been done, you can get from the previous DIT algorithm. So just we will be finding out the binary number, like it is 0 or 1, 2. So 0, 0, 0 will be binary. 001 010, then it's bit reversal, this is binary reversal is 0000, and 100 this will be 0, 1, 0. So it is x of 0, x of 4, x of this is 2. So this will be the at the output. So bit reversal will be there in case of DIF at the output. But in case of DIT, the bit reversal was there in case of DITFFT. So at the input bit reversal will be there in case of DITFFT algorithm. Okay, but at the output, bit reversal will be there in case of DIFFT algorithms. Okay, so these two reduced flow graphs could be remembered by you. Yeah, just go through it, and after solving some numericals, you can finally remember this. So there are some basic difference. So in DIT, the difference is like at this point we were using the multiplier element. Okay, but in this case, the multiplier is being used at the end of, means after getting the H0, we are getting the multiplier. Okay, so here there is no multiplier starting at the starting. After that, G0, G1, G2, G3, there is no multiplier next to it. H0 is having multipliers W80, W81. So these multipliers you need to keep in mind. And where this minus sign is there, so keep this minus sign also into the consideration. So how it is different from the DIT and DIF algorithms. Okay, so this is how we should be calculating the DIT and DIF algorithms techniques, how we can use for calculation of DFT values. In terms of complexity, one point I would like to just note it to you. Like if any system is there, so how it is having their complexity being changed. So just last point you need to see. After that we will go for the closing. Okay. So just to find out the complexity, like how we can find the complexity. Even you are the computer science students, so you might have the knowledge like to find out the complexity. So we will be finding out the complexity of DIT and DIF. So in case of complexity here, basically the complexity is always in terms of components that we will be using to design these algorithms. The components that will be requiring to design are multipliers and adders. These are the only two elements that will be required to design or calculate DFT by using these two methods. So how many multipliers and how many adders are required, based on that we will be defining like how complex that algorithm is. Okay, so we will just see in case of DIT algorithms. Suppose we are doing the complexity calculation, then we can see like in case of this, the number of multipliers that we will be requiring depends on the multiplications we are performing. So just to see the first method, like direct method. So in case of direct method, so in this case, the number of multipliers, complex multipliers we should be calculating. So in case of multipliers, we are having the formula x of k summation n equals to 0 to n minus 1 x of n w n to the power k n. Okay, so this is the final formula. So here the complexity is in terms of number of complex multipliers, complex multiplication that we should be performing will depends on the total number of the n is ranging from 0 to n minus 1. So total n terms will be there. Okay, so each time n type of multipliers will be there. okay, for one calculation, like x k equals to 0, we need to find out. So in this k, for k equals to 0, n number of multipliers will be there. Okay, so multipliers will be n for one calculation. Similarly, for n k should be varying from 0 to n minus 1. So again, n times k will be varying. So total multipliers will be n into n. Okay, is it okay? Like, for suppose k x k is equal to this. So this one calculation is requiring n number of multipliers. But for different k, that k should be varying from 0 to n minus 1. So to k n times k should be varying. So total n into n, that is n square number of multipliers we will be requiring to find out this. Similarly, to find out adders, we will be requiring n minus 1 for the first stage. So for the first calculation, we will be requiring n minus 1. But similarly, to find out n minus n terms, n minus 1 times n number of adders will be required. Okay. So this is the direct method of calculation of DFT. Now we will see the by using FFT algorithms. So either we are taking DIT or DIF, the similar number of multiplier and adders will be requiring. So just see, like in case of multipliers in FFT, so we are having, so after first stage, the n minus 2 number of, suppose we are having n by 2 stages, and at each, sorry, we are having dividing n point DFT to n by 2 and n by 2. Okay, so at n by 2 DFT calculations are there. Okay, and it is having the number of stages. So number of stages is given by log 2 to the base 2 into n. So at each stage, suppose this is the number of stages, this is number of stages in this FFT algorithm. So if it is n equals to 8, three stages will be there. So these stages will be multiplied by number of multipliers used in one stage. Okay, so if n by 2 is the number of butterflies, then total n by 2 into number of stages will be required. So this much of multipliers will be requiring in case of FFT algorithms. Okay, so this will be the multipliers. Okay, similarly, the number of adders that will be required is given by total, we will be requiring n by 2, log to the base n, log n to the base 2. This is the number of stages, and each stage will be having n by 2 point DFT, and 2 times will be there the additions. Sorry, so 2 will be multiplied. So these number of additions we will be requiring. Okay, so these are the total number of adders. So total number of stages are given by like log n to the base 2. At each stage, we are having n by 2 butterflies that are required, and each butterfly will be requiring 2 adders. So like in the smallest butterfly that we are having is this one. So at each butterfly, we will be requiring 2 adders. Either it is subtractor or adder, it will be considered as a adder only. Okay, so 2 at each butterfly will be requiring. So this n by 2 number of butterflies will be there, and that will be multiplied by 2 for 2 number of adders, and total that much of stages are there. So this will be the number of adders required in case of FFT algorithm, and this much of multipliers will be required at in the FFT. So from there we can compare like how many numbers are being different. Suppose n is equals to 8. So n is equals to 8 is there. So in case of normal method, it will be 8 to the power 2, that is 64. And similarly, the multiplier we are finding out, this is FFT, and this is direct. So 64 multipliers will be there. In case of FFT, if it is 8, so it will be 3 into 4, that is 12 multipliers will be required. in case of adders. So in direct method, 8 minus 7, that is 56. 8 into 7, that is 56 number of adders will be required. But in this method, so it will be 4 into 2, that is 8. 8 into 3, 24 adders will be required. So from there, we can compare like what is the complexity difference is there in case of direct method and in case of FFT with the method. Okay, so that is okay. So the first unit almost we have completed. Some numerical problems we will be solving in the further classes. So up to here, if anyone is having any doubt, you can ask either directly into the class, or you can just mail me, or you can send the WhatsApp also. So your doubts will be clear. So you have your unit, you can say the quiz is there. So up to this point, the quiz will be having the questions, and your first unit is over from there onwards. And at 1 p.m. on the Monday, you will be having your quiz. So सभी को आप बता देना कि आपका quiz जो है Monday को या 1 बजे से होगा, और जो भी अभी तक पढ़ाया गया है उससे आपको आएगा, और first unit आपका complete होता है यहाँ पे. अगर किसी को कोई doubt है आप पूछ सकते हो किसी भी तरीके का. Yes, किसी को कोई doubt है?
No, sir.
Okay, then so सभी को आप एक बार कंफर्म कर देना ग्रुप में डाल करके क्विज के लिए, और क्विज से रिलेटेड कोई भी किसी को इशू है आप पहले भी इन्फॉर्म कर दो, ठीक है? गूगल क्लासरूम या फिर गूगल
सर क्विज कैसे होगा?
ऑनलाइन होगा, गूगल क्विज के थ्रू होगा, ठीक है? आपका
अच्छा, मल्टीपल चॉइस
हाँ मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस होंगे. हाँ,